I'm sorry, guys. And you're gonna suffer. It's like, I know you need to get that appendix out and it's causing you harm, but I have promised to do no harm. I'm sorry, guys. Fucking morons. Barely, why is this in quotation marks? This is exactly what it does. Why? For anyone not aware, Arkansas put forward the SAFE Act, which was written by the Family Research Council. Let's have a look at this. Family Research Council actively recommends and supports the Save Adolescents from Experimentation Act. Oh boy, what a fucking name. One sex has never assigned at birth. It is always objective and observable by a time of birth. What's the difference? Propagating an ideology of fluid sexuality, which is not what people do, is not only undermines a significant understanding of human anatomy, but also damages the lives of the next generation. So, what we understand here is that this isn't a scientific understanding of the human anatomy, because the science literature lies. What they're referring to are trans people, okay? And the broad base of the literature resides in trans people's identities being valid, in a separation between gender and sex, and gender being socially constructed and sex also being socially constructed to an extent. Okay? One of those is bimodal, one of those is on a spectrum, sex being bimodal. But also the staggering growth of transgenderism. What a fucking word. Has left children vulnerable to life-altering procedures such as puberty-blocking drugs. So just a heads up, puberty-blocking drugs, not life-altering. The only outcome from puberty blockers, if you go off of puberty blockers as we understand them, is brittle bones. You may have osteoporosis if you don't work to counteract the calcium milking properties of hormone replacement. Of hormone blocking, sorry, not hormone replacement. Cross-sex hormones, which is what they're talking about here, HRT, hormone replacement therapy, and irreversible surgeries, which is true. But a very small number of people actually go through with surgery. These unscientific, destructive gender transition procedures. So, in the terms of HRT, what we understand is that there are some irreversible parts of it, that an incredibly low amount of people detransition, and then those that do have the risk of being infertile may keep, if they're M to F going back to M, they may keep their boobies. If they're the other way around, they may keep some of their facial hair. But other than that, there's the risk of infertility, and that's it, right? It's not perfect, but a very, very low number of people detransition, and those that do detransition usually do so because of societal pressure. I think it was like of the 4% of detransitioners, I think it was 76% from memory. I could be getting the number wrong, but 76% said it was because of social pressures, aka their family members not supporting them. What we understand, family support causes, there's the famous number, right? The 41%, right? And that is the number of, that's the risk of suicide attempt from memory, or completed suicide. No, I think it's suicide attempt. Wait, I want to make sure I got that right. Attempted suicide. Yep, sick. So that's a suicide attempt, and that goes down drastically when you have family support and friend support, right? I think it goes down to around 10%, which still isn't ideal, but it goes down even lower with gender confirmation, surgeries, and hormone replacement therapies, right? It's just support people. Be nice to them. It's not that fucking hard, which is the opposite of what this bill aims to do. Should not be allowed to interrupt the development of children and irreversibly alter their bodies. At this point, to be clear, puberty blockers are done at the point of puberty. whether you want to call these people children at that point, I'm not sure, right? They're teenagers, whatever. Children here seems like very inflammatory language, but this is a very inflammatory language piece of legislation, or proposed legislation anyway. These are not four-year-olds getting these drugs, right? Because four-year-olds don't look like males or females, okay? Four-year-olds look like fucking four-year-olds. The Safe Act addresses this critical need. In 2020, 19 states introduced bills banning gender transition procedures on minors. This is cringe. In this year, 18 states have introduced similar legislation. There is a reason why this SAFE Act is one of the first ones to have passed, unfortunately, an incredibly red state. Some include criminal penalties, which is cringe. Others make gender transition for minors child abuse. Many do not address the insurance coverage. We believe that a more carefully calibrated approach is warranted, and this AFE Act is our response to that growing need. Legislate, so let's have a look on the side here. Gender transition is an experiment. No treatment can change a child's genetic composition, and no studies have demonstrated long-term benefits. This is false. We can look at... I've got a couple on hand right here, actually. Let's have a look here. This is, and these are just a handful of ones that I picked out, okay? This is Hess, Nito, Rubin, and Senf, and Panic from 2007, from memory? 2014. Okay, let's have a look here. Results. 46% of the patients filled out and returned the questionnaires, a mean of 5 years after the surgery. 90% said their expectations for life as a woman were fulfilled postoperatively. 85% saw themselves as a woman. 61% were satisfied. 26% were very satisfied with their outward appearance as a woman. 37% were satisfied and very satisfied. So these people are generally pretty happy with the procedure. Where are we? It's been a while since that's the research paper on... Where are we? I remember, I think this was just going over the surgeries for it. Yep, here we go. A community sample of 573 trans women with the history of sex work completed a one-time self-report survey that assessed, to be clear, 573 is a lot. This is a fraction of a fraction of the population, okay? In multivariate models, we found that social, psychological, and medical gender affirmation were significant predictors of lower depression and higher self-esteem, while no domains of affirmation were significantly associated with suicidal ideation. Findings support the need for accessible and affordable transitioning resources for transgender women in order to promote better quality of life among an already vulnerable population. Now, keep in mind, a lot of these studies are out of date. These are 2014, 2017. 5 years is usually what we look for in terms of, like, scientific studies. Obviously not perfect. Usually you'll have to go back sometimes. But with trans people being significantly more visible over the last few years, I would expect to see more studies in the near future that are going to reinforce a lot of these things that we already understand from probably worse, what we call them, worse studies, right? But... what we understand here is that this is false. There have been multiple studies that do this. There are actually like several long... Those, what I showed you, weren't longitudinal studies. They were surveys that were post-operative surveys like a couple of years after. There are longitudinal studies that also show this. I can find them if any of y'all need me to find them. The government should not force taxpayers to fund it, insurers to cover it, or children to should be subjected to it. Insurers should cover medical... provisions. That is what health insurance does, right? So they should cover it. Children are not subjected to it. Children often choose this, right? People usually understand from the first few years before the age of four that they are usually not the gender that they were assigned at birth, okay? Kids are pretty fucking good at knowing who they are. They're way smarter than we give them credit for. And taxpayers should be forced to fund it because they're forced to fund healthcare expenditure, okay? There's a whole bunch of shit that people get funded that a lot of people don't like, okay? The fact that I have to subsidize the Catholic Church for me is pretty shit, but I understand I'm a taxpayer and I live here. So It is what it is. The Safe Act also provides legal remedies for minors who have been permanently disfigured or sterilized. Good thing to sing it. What? We're not spoiling it. All right. The long-held understanding that human sexuality... That's... See, this is like a really weird thing that like when you only use like the one word, it kind of like falls into the other thing, right? Like you have trouble describing things when you limit vocabulary. So when you don't separate gender and sex, you fall into things like human sexuality, right? Which what we understand when we talk about sexuality is usually our attraction to other people, right? And that's clearly not what they're talking about here. So it's like the whole like the 1984 where they try and limit language to limit thought. You know what I mean? Having more words to describe different things is a good thing. It's sick. Okay. This is why, like, so when I usually I'm a debate bro, right? And one of the first things, and you can go and see me do this. You can go to my YouTube channel, right? So if you go to my link tree, which is somewhere, I think it's down below, right? You go to my YouTube channel. You can see a debate I have with Bryson Gray, right? Who is a conservative hip hop artist. And one of the things I ask him, right, is he repeats this idea over and over that no, before they changed the definition, sex and gender were the same thing. Sex and gender are the same thing. Sex and gender are the same thing, right? And they won't even engage with the ideas. One of the things I'll do is I will ask them about, I'll say, right, you can just keep calling it gender. Gender is sex, right? It's the same word. Go for it. You got me. What about schmender? Right? And they'll be like, schmender? What do you mean? Right? So then they'll actually fucking listen to what you have to say because they'll listen to the definition. And because the definition is explaining something that absolutely exists, right? There is absolutely a public experience of what we perceive to be like a man or a woman and that grouping collective that defines it, and that you can misgender people. When you're misgendering people, there's actually something that's going on there, right? Because you're not looking at, like, you don't have, like, x-ray, like, chromo vision to see their chromosomes, or, like, you can't see through their pants into their genitals, right? What you're perceiving is, like, some societal idea. And there's a good reason to talk about that, those expectations and why they're separate and what's going on there, right? And have the ability to have that discussion rather than just talk about like what's going on endocrinologically. Is that the word? We'll go with that. Having the ability to talk about the science there, that's cool, right? And talking about like bimodal sex, that's its own subject. There's a whole bunch of cool shit going on there. There's also a whole bunch of cool and interesting shit going on with gender, our expectations, how we, how much is spent on MH services in Vic? MH? So the best argument against is gender schmender. I guess, like, it's just one that I found effective, right? It's not an argument. It's more like getting them to actually engage with the thing that you're talking about. Because they get so hung up on the idea that, like, no, gender and sex are the same thing. They changed the dictionary. How could they do this, right? Instead of just engaging with the idea, mental health. I'm not sure. I know that Victoria does, like, good spending on it in general. But the idea is that, like, when you do that, it forces them to engage with the idea, right? It's like a rhetorical framing device for them to actually listen to what you say when you mean gender is different from sex, as opposed to them thinking like three steps ahead, right? What you want to do is force people to engage you on your position, is to force them to actually listen to what you have to say, right? There's ways you can have a discussion, and usually it's going to be being as non-combative as possible, to get people to actually listen to the thing you have to say, because there's just going to be a more interesting conversation there, right? Like, they might have an idea that we don't actually societally define gender, that there is something intrinsic that gets played out every single time, right? That might not be accounted for. There might be like some chemical thing they have like an idea about. Instead of just being like rooted to this like ideological tie that gender is sex, they changed the word on us, how could they, right? Getting them to force to deal with the actual definition and the actual argument is the root of the issue here, right? So like that's what I mean when like you just have more words to describe things. I don't know why you want to limit language, right? To me, this is actually an attack on freedom, right? Because it's attacking freedom of expression and freedom of thought. Like, not having more words, not being able to change our language and understand how things go as we go forward is limiting us in a way that we don't need to, right? Like, it seems, and most of the times I talk about it, I'm like, they never actually have a problem with the actual idea of it itself, right? And they never actually think about where it comes from and why it's different. When they're forced to actually contend with what it is, they have no argument, because there is no argument against it, right? Because everyone's misgendered someone before. Oh, here's like an old one. Wait, we'll go over me running this argument in real time, really quickly, and then I'll come back to the paper. Because it's a 5-minute run, so we can see how it works. Because there's going to be like some like levels to it, right? So, notepad. Because like gender and sex separation is like a really interesting thing. So like you've got the idea that like misgendering exists, right? We've all misgendered someone. Because this itself actually implies that there's a separation between gender and sex, right? So, implies separation of gender and sex, right? Because it means that you've identified something that's separate from what the person actually is, right? You can like look behind someone and see that they've got long hair and they've got a pretty nice bum and they may have like a hippie waist, right? And then they'll turn around and it's like a dude. I've got a friend like that actually. My mate Dylan does like he plays guitar and he's got long hair and you know he's a fucking like somewhat chubby boy, but he's chubby in like these weird spots. And if you look behind him, it looks like a chick, right? And what we understand here is we're actually perceiving our idea of what a woman is versus what a woman actually is. So if we go here, right, I'll quickly show you like where I ran the argument. This was a guy called, this is last year. Yeah. A guy called Armenian Legend who floats around Discord. Most people want to talk to rather than waiting 26 years. Or someone to talk to rather than 26 years. Yeah, exactly, right? We should just have, like... And I know it's 26 years, because, like, Viv has talked about, like, the waiting lines in the UK. But the psychologists, right, we should just, like, have the route to it. In Australia, we could be better in terms of, like, the way that we handle... Mental health. I know that's something we fall short on in particular, right? The headspace is great. Headspace is only for under 25s though. And a lot of like older men get left behind. I think from memory, older male suicide rates in Australia are spiking incredibly high. Anyways, so here's like us. I'll speed it up so you don't have to listen to my fucking shitty voice on my shitty microphone for too long. But here's like the idea of like running that argument that I was talking about.
Giving birth or nurturing, whatever. Just nope. You're saying
just
the colors of
how we call people,
blue, pink,
he or she. Yeah. So just things that are descriptively the case, right? The way we label people is he or she or they, right? When we look at people and we give them some kind of pronoun, which may be different from the pronoun that we would use that has to do with their birth sex, it's descriptively the case. If people present a certain way, we usually label them a certain way.
Because, like, for example, colors, I can say yes and no.
Pardon?
Was that sorry? But did you say something, Dawn?
No, I didn't say anything.
Okay.
Colors, it could be a social construct and it cannot be a social construct. For example, like,
by the way, whenever you're trying to engage with someone who doesn't agree with your ideas or doesn't understand your ideas, go out of your way to not use the fucking buzzwords. Explain the underlying concept, don't use the words, okay? Because any extra work they have to do when they're thinking about these things is another extra piece of work that they're not going to jump on board with. And this is talking to like older people. I think non-binary is right here when we say that like this should just be like in education, right? I saw like Prager like kicking up the shits about the fact that we're going to have like gender study discussions going from like K through to 6 to K and 6 and 12 and whatever, right? But like I mentioned before, kids understand at like by 4 years old like what kind of person they are, and it might help them to understand, to have that heard in the classroom, because they might not talk about it at home. So sex ed's another reason, like that's the reason why we do sex ed, is because like some houses just don't want to talk about sex ed, so you have to teach it in the classroom or you're going to have problems later down the road as a society, which is what we're having now.
Like, say, females might be more attracted to, say, more emotional. They're more into colors in terms of, like, flowers or whatever. So certain...
This is very cringe, by the way, what he's saying.
Colors of the flowers might more reflect, like, pinkish or whatever towards
them. So it sounds like you can play sex and gender.
Whereas males would be, like, in war, blood, and, like, black, and, like, whatever. It kind of, like, fits more into what their daily job is.
So do you agree that there's some separation in sex and gender?
I wouldn't say there's a separation between sex and gender. I would say there's a separation between... what someone has to do based off their biology and what society.
Why do people have to do things based off their biology? That sounds like a really strange assault claim to make.
Because that's how humans function. Without it, they'll cease to exist.
So what he said there, we'll just go back to it. The reason why I pulled him up on it.
Gender, I would say there's a separation between what someone has to do based off their biology and what society
Why do people have to do things based off their biology?
Yeah. So he said that, like, there's things that people have to do, which is saying, like, when you say someone has to do something, someone ought to do something, right? Because like, ought implies can. And what he's saying here is that, like, people ought to be a certain way. That's why I called him up on it to say, hey, we were describing descriptive statements before, right? We were saying the way that the world is, and maybe we had, like, some disagreement about the way the world is, but we were talking about the way that the world is. We're trying to describe things. And he's saying, hey, this is the way that people ought to be. So he is trying to, like, shift the goalpost a little bit here.
That sounds like a really strange assault claim to make.
Because that's how humans function. Without it, they'll cease to exist.
So because X thing has Y function, X thing must act a certain way. Is this a correct statement for a characterization?
Well, as a society,
if you want to have nice conversations with people, always take what you think their position is, repeat it back to them. It helps. It keeps everyone on side. It means that people aren't going to talk about, like, strawmanning or feel like they're being strawmanned. Because if you get something wrong, they're just going to say, oh, no, I meant this, right? And you've gone out of your way to clarify. It's a very helpful tool. It makes for, like, very smooth flowing conversations. And part of conversations is trust, right? If the person you're talking to doesn't trust you, they're not going to listen to what you have to say. And there are certain things, like, obviously, like, if you come in and say, like, I'm a lefty, and they identify as a right winger, you're automatically in, like, an enemy group, right? So if you can avoid those things, try to. It's why I generally say, oh, I like unions. That's, like, despite, like, me holding, like, a lot of positions that most people consider left wing, I just say, I hold this position or this position, right? Because I don't want to come off as being, like, a bad guy to them, right? Because, no, I can get along with most people, I think. I'm a pretty agreeable guy. Being agreeable is a part of these conversations. That doesn't always help to come out and just, like, shit on people, like, down their throats. Be, like, big, tough guy, dude. Like, oh, are you fucking stupid? Oh. Like, this idea of, like, overpowering is, like, very silly to me when we have these kinds of conversations. Even though I'm pretty hostile in this conversation, I'll be real. But you can be that level of a bit aggressive and still keep people on side.
Yes. But, like, for some individual, no.
What? Society is made up of individuals. I'm really confused here.
We live in a society.
Like, for example, let's say we're America right now. There's, like, a national war going. Let's say World War III is about to start. If let's say World War III is about to start in, like, 30 years. And all of a sudden, say all of us refuse to reproduce because we think it's a social construct. We shouldn't. Our population drops to a very low level. We can't defend. We get wiped out. Just an example. But if an individual...
Real things that exist and that we give value to, right? Like, for example, currency is a social construct. It doesn't have any inherent value, but because we've agreed that this thing has value, it has value, right? It's similar to, like, gender or any of these other things, right?
Yeah, but I wouldn't
just
say...
Just like how we determine the women.
So that's usually, like, if anyone asks what a social construct is, currency is the best one. And, like, currency and gender obviously don't map on one-to-one. None of this shit maps on one-to-one, right? But the underlying concept is there. That, that you have, like, this thing that has value, that we assign value to. And it's same as gender. We have, like, a value assigned to gender. We have a value assigned to, like, the way a person presents. And how much, it's especially when you're talking to right wingers, they value it very strongly. They have a high value on gender roles.
I don't have any value.
Just gonna ignore that one.
Yeah, but one is biological, like, because it's associated with biology. The other one is tools that we've
gender
used.
Gender has nothing to do with biology.
That's a disagreement, because I believe gender and sex is the same thing. It's just people are trying to...
So if I showed you 1,000 photos of people, right, from the waist up with clothes, not from the waist up even, with clothes on, right? Could you tell me what every single one of their sex is? And we're going to take this conversation to be, and I don't know if you disagree, as one's chromosomal outfitting, right? So whether they're XX or XY, do you think you could do that? Would you be willing to make a bet on that?
Like what?
You
could 100% correctly identify 1,000 people with clothes on as to what their chromosomes are.
I did have Bryson Gray say that he could do this. Apparently, Bryson Gray reckons he clocked Blair White. He thinks. Even though at the end of that discussion, he wasn't willing to do that with 8 people. So that was pretty funny. Don't believe anyone who thinks they can like hyperclock people. They just can't.
Does your perception matter?
I would say like an overwhelming majority, an average human would be able to tell the difference. As long as there's not,
you'd be able to tell what with 100% certainty on 1,000 people.
As say, there's no external influence, like no drugs, no surgery, nothing. Just as man and woman is born.
Why does that matter?
Because it greatly matters.
Why does it matter? I'm literally just talking about perception.
Yeah, why does perception of their chromosomes matter?
So I'm saying,
yeah, I'm just asking you to like look at people with 1,000, like 1,000 different people with clothes on. So why does it matter if they've had surgery or not? People get surgery all the time. Women get bigger breasts.
That's what I'm saying is if there's no surgery, if there's no human intervention, 99% of the time, maybe 95% of the time, it should be easy to be able to tell.
Why would this matter? Why would it matter if human intervention?
Because there are, say, some women in, like, say, in the Middle East or whatever, might have, like, mustaches, so if their hair is short or whatever, who knows? If they're flat-chested, who knows? Might have some difficulty, but you should still be able to somewhat tell.
You should be able to somewhat tell. Why, from what, like, do you think that all people have these characteristics all the time?
Well, overwhelming majority, like I said, should be able to tell. So your argument is that it's like saying, what if this person, what if that person? But it's like a very small percentage of the population where it's irrelevant.
I will be very clear on what my position is, right? I hold a descriptive position of gender that one's performance in society is generally how we label them with their gender, right? This has nothing to do with identity.
So what I was describing here was how we assign gender. So like, just to clarify something really quickly here, my position is that gender is something that's both forced onto people, right? That's the descriptive, the outside of society one, and something that's an identity. Gender is both an identity, something you hold, and something that society forces onto you, usually in the form of pronouns.
I hold that as separate, right? But the way we descriptively use gender in society, that is he, she, they, is based entirely on appearance, right? It doesn't matter if on this end.
It's not just on appearance, it's on performance. I'm a little bit inaccurate here.
And, right, it wouldn't matter if someone had surgery or not. It's basically how we look at them and we see a he or a she or a they, right? Even people who completely disagree with this theory still hold to this. A really good example of this is Ben Shapiro has to constantly correct himself for correctly gendering Blair White, right? Because the way we label people with pronouns is based on how they look.
Now,
there are exceptions that people make to this. That is, someone may say, hey, I identify this way. And because we have respect for that person, we do so, right?
Yeah, but that's one self-feeling. Reality doesn't care.
I'm talking about reality. You're right. Facts don't care about your feelings.
That was a snappy little ender there. But that's like basically running the argument. And sometimes I'll run it like, you've misgendered someone before, right? And someone will say, if anyone's being like honest with you, they'll say yes. And if anyone's lying to you, they'll say no. And you can relate like the way through misgendering, how you get to that. But that's basically like running a short version of the argument. That was like 6 minutes long. That was from last year. I thought it was longer ago. Yeah. So that's running that argument and a little bit on thing. And by the way, non-binary, you're right. Because we agree on this, that like, don't use, if you're talking about someone about like communism or like socialism, just talk about the concepts. People have like a bad feeling with the words and they might not understand you. They don't want to, every time you say those words, like if you say like, oh, this is a regressive tax, right? Instead of saying like, yeah, this regressive tax is regressive, 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 like a, like some fucking like malformed Dave Rubin. Instead, just say that, like, this tax just affects poor people. Why would you want to fuck poor people like this? This is better rhetoric anyway. Anyways, back to the Arkansas bill. Where is it? Yep. So when approaching the very delicate condition of gender incongruity, a disconnect between one's physiological self-perceived gender identity and one's sex, or gender dysphoria, the ideal of subjective sexuality has been elevated. I've never heard subjective sexuality. And people who suffer incongruity or dissonance are now told they can correct their sexuality characteristics. However, this ideology of subjective sexuality is not a victimless dogma. It now targets society's most vulnerable members, children and adolescents who experience... So they even separate here between children and adolescents. So just all this stuff from before is just false then. Everything up here is false because it means they're not referring to 17-year-olds, 16-year-olds, 10-year-olds, like up down through to like 12, 13-year-olds, people who are going through puberty that would be using puberty blockers. They are just thinking that like 4-year-olds are taking puberty blockers. Rather than provide help such children and adolescents in need, transgender ideology promotes the radical medical interventions. Not radical, it's backed by science. Increasing the use of drugs to block normal puberty and cross-sex hormones. This is normal, you're right. cross-sex hormones and generate stomach surgery to create the superficial appearance of conformity with minors' perceived sexual identity. Now, I don't know anyone who is generally underage getting gender reassignment surgery. It seems like it's usually adults who can make adult decisions that are doing this one. And from what I understand, from what I read a little while back, most people aren't getting gender reassignment surgery of itself. So if I look at gender reassignment surgery rates, here we go, demographical and transgender trends. So we can scroll down a little so we can see exactly who's getting gender reassignment surgery, right? So it says it even separates between top and bottom surgery from memory, right? So GCS overall, gender confirmation surgery in trans men is 42 to 54%, in trans women it's 28%, and in non-binary is 9%, right? General surgery, this is bottom surgery, is only like 5 to 15%, right? In trans men it's a little bit higher, so hysterectomy being like the breast removal. Phalloplasty, I think, is to do with, these are both like genital ones, I think. Trans women, non-binary, certain, is 5 to 13%, so not a lot. Non-binary, assigned at male birth. Non-binary, assigned female at birth. Hysterectomy in non-binary. Chest or breast surgery, 8 to 25%. This is still incredibly low, despite being, you know, it also blocks the use of blockers with cancer treatment as a consequence. Oh shit, really? Because I know that they use blockers, wait, no, they don't use blockers in menopause. I'm dumb. Yeah, it's blockers in cancer treatment. That's an interesting one. So, yeah, the surgery isn't prevalent at all, right? Let's have a look. So they keep bringing it up like it's this big boogeyman. It's not used in children, right? It's not used in adolescents for the most part. I'm sure there might be a few. It's usually use of puberty blockers, which we know are safe and don't have long-term consequences outside of osteoporosis. And even then, that can be counteracted and isn't necessarily as big of a problem as we understand. And the cross-sex hormones can also be reversed, and that there are serious consequences to cross-sex hormones, but not super serious, right? Nothing that's like crippling. The SAFE Act would prevent the vulnerable from experimental procedures that cause, by the way, this is why that British ruling was so incredibly fucking stupid. Endometriosis. Yeah, exactly. Dude, endometriosis is such a fucking big deal. A lot of people are having endometriosis. Incredibly high. How often is, how regular is endometriosis? I think it's like 1 in 8. Endometriosis. So for people who don't know, endometriosis is the peeling of the skin from the ovaries. It can be called incredibly painful. Not skin, sorry, tissue that normally lines the uterus. How common? Eleven percent of women between 15 and 45. That's fucking rolling a D10, right? And you're gonna fuck all those people just because you hate trans people, who make up like less than 0.1% of the less than 1% of the population. I think it's 0.6 now, or is it 0.06? I can't remember. The SAFE Act would prevent the trauma of the vulnerable from experimental procedures that cause psychological trauma for minors dealing with gender dysphoria. If they are dealing with gender dysphoria, the psychological trauma comes from not having that gender dysphoria alleviated. I hate this shit. I hate this shit so much. Jesus fucking Christ. Nice meme. I like this. That is a very good meme. I'm gonna fucking smash that like button, dude. That's a good ass meme. I appreciate that. Really? What am I doing? Okay. Despite claims to the contrary, these gender transition procedures are often not reversible. Even temporarily pausing puberty has permanent consequences for the human body. Note that they don't cite what that consequence is, or how it's alleviated, or where it comes from, because they know that it's not a large consequence. Why? I hate these people. I hate them so much. Holy shit. How can you be this dishonest? How can you be this dishonest? And it fucking temporarily, why is this in quotation marks? This is exactly what it does. Why? Research has not shown these procedures are effective in accomplishing their stated purpose, except they are. I showed some of them on fucking stream like 15 minutes ago. This is Oh, this is balls to the wall, brain against the fucking floor, stupid. They have serious negative side effects, up to and including permanent sterilization. That's true. Thus violating the most fundamental principle of medical ethics, versus do no harm. This is like, if you were to take this and put this to like any other fucking like medical ideology, like going, well, there is a chance that when we put you under, right, that you might not get up. Now, because of that chance, we're not going to perform this procedure and you're going to suffer, right? Because we promise to do no harm, right? Actually, we promise to do no harm, so we can't do the surgery because we'd be cutting into you, and that's doing harm, right? Like, I'm sorry, guys. Like, I know you need to get that appendix out and it's causing you harm, but I have promised to do no harm. I'm sorry, guys. Fucking morons. The SAFE Act addresses these harms by preventing physicians from administering any form of treatment that would seek to change an adolescent's sex-related physical characteristics in support of... Wait, that's not true. They stop puberty at 10 or 2, so you know you will not lose fertility. From what I understand by talking to trans people on cross-sex hormones, that the cross-sex hormones can cause a loss of fertility, no? I could be wrong. My only experience is like talking to people who are on the medication. I haven't gone like super hard into the... I went super hard in the puberty blockers reading, but I didn't go super hard in the cross-sex hormone one because there's a lot of drugs and I don't want to have to bother learn all the stuff. Okay, I'm not a medical professional. Oh, yeah. Okay, cool. Non-binary, appreciate the context. I'll be carrying that for a while then. No, I appreciate the... I appreciate the correction, I really do. Because you're right, puberty blockers don't cause you to lose fertility, and if they're cross-sex hormones, you're right, cool. Yeah, puberty blockers don't, they only cause osteoporosis, and the blockers are fine, and you're only going to take the blockers up until you're an adult. You're 100% correct. I don't know why I didn't say that before. I'm a dumb fuck, I apologize. All right. Gender transition is an experiment, not true. Medical care, and there is no treatment that can change a person's genetic composition. I mean, there's plenty of treatments that can change people's genetic composition. That's literally what cancer treatment aims to do. And no studies have demonstrated long-term benefits from gender transition. This is false. I've shown them. The government should not force taxpayers to fund it or insurers to cover it. And children should not be subjected to it. This is just an ought claim with no argument. This is what we call in the business cringe. The SAFE Act prohibits physicians from administering gender transitions procedure to minors, prohibits taxpayers and medical insurance policies from paying for them, and provides legal remedies for minors who have been permanently disfigured or sterilized by them. Cringe, cringe, cringe. I mean, this last one is like, if people want to detransition, they should have the same level of government support as those transitioning, and the government should be covering the transition, right? So if there are issues with it and they need to detransition for whatever reason, right, that there was like, maybe there was a medical misdiagnosis, which is incredibly unlikely, incredibly, incredibly, incredibly unlikely. Like another side effect, stops doctors from stopping puberty in fat girls. Okay. Luteinizing hormone secretion, Jesus Christ, these fucking words. Hormone simulation tests, not basic goals. Objective methods, results, and 10 or 2 stage goals. Peak simulated LH on Geno. Conclusion in girls with central precocious puberty. Increased BMI is associated with slightly lower peak LH levels at early pubertal stages. This association was not valid in 10 or stage 4 girls. Okay, cool. So many big fucking words. Why do scientists do this? They make their fucking literature like super impenetrable. And I swear they do it on purpose. Right. Yeah. Legislative findings, providing a comprehensive study of scientific, medical, and history data relating to gender transition procedures. I mean, yeah, we should be funding gender transition procedures and studies following them, right? Like, having more research isn't a bad thing. Oh, hey, agronomics, good to see you. There's nothing wrong with this. Like... But it seems like what they want is like a bent version of it, which is really dumb. define sex in biological terms. They already do this. Related to the reproductive or potential capability in contrast with psychological gender, they already do this, as well as defining gender transition procedures to include the use of puberty blocking drugs, cross-sex hormones, and non... Don't they already do this? Am I misreading this? Is this dumb? It seems like this is something they already do, unless the wording is... Is there something wrong with the wording here that I'm not getting? In contrast to psychological gender, which it does, as well as gender transition procedures to include the use of puberty blocking drugs, cross-sex hormones, and non-genital and genital gender reassignment surgery. This is... Maybe this is just what they're defining for. What are you covering? We're just going over the Arkansas law that prohibited trans people from getting healthcare. It's going to be the final segment for today. Short stream. Exception for those with verifiable abilities of sex development, those who have intersex conditions, treatment of complications. Is it... Okay, prohibits gender transition procedures. There we go. It's defining it for the fact that they could prohibit it for minors and the public funding of it, the insurance coverage of, or referral of for such procedures. Now, to be clear, most of this stuff can't be done for minors. Puberty blocking can, which is good. Like, you should do puberty blocking up until they're an adult so they make that decision. Now, I think it's like 96% of the people who go on puberty blockers do go through to transitioning. So the argument's there for not even bothering the puberty blockers. I personally would feel better about having the puberty blockers. I feel like it's just like a slam dunk. It's like, hey, they can hold off until they're old enough to decide for themselves. You don't have to fight that like visual battle, but like the other side of that is like, should trans people suffer for 4 years? Because why are puberty blockers beneficial for those questioning their identity? Because it allows them to hit like a pause button on puberty. Because once you go through puberty, you can't un-go through puberty, right? Whereas like holding onto it and deciding whether they want to like never go through it, and because they already understand that they're like a woman, right, or a man, or neither, or both, to varying degrees. Then they can, then at that choice, they can, then at that age, like where they're able to, they can make that decision, right? It's just like easy. Now, if you like, I am sympathetic to that argument. If a person didn't question their identity, but they weren't ready for puberty, should they be allowed to take puberty blockers? I mean, it seems like, so from the research I understand now, it seems fine-ish. I'm not sure. I feel like yes, but I'd rather they see their doctor and the doctor makes that decision. Enforcement and cause of action to bring claims in for compliance within 2 years, 2 years after the age of a severability clause. Okay, so we have read now the best version of this legislation. And it's been fucking banned! So Arkansas's House is it just the House? I think they just the House at state level. Voted this past, which banned trans healthcare for youth. Who makes the decision on taking puberty blockers, the parents or the child? Well, wouldn't it be both? Like, parents are usually the guardians of the children who make medical decisions for them, and the child works with the psychologist, the psychiatrist, and the doctor to come to some agreeable level position. Who makes the ultimate decision? I mean, you would hope that... Wait, no? What did I say no to? What am I... Did I say something dumb? Let me know. Because from what I understand, psychologist, psychiatrist, and doctor work together because psychiatrist issues the drugs. It's a multidisciplinary decision. Okay, cool. So I didn't... Yeah, that's why I said psychiatrist, psychologist, and doctor. Though these are usually people that work within the gender clinics together, right? Because it's usually the medical professionals that say, that suggest like a treatment path, and then it's up to the people to go through that treatment path, right? Or am I like, so you have the social worker, the psych, andro, parents, and the child. Is the andro is like a term for a psych, because when you say psych team, you mean psych and psychologist and psychiatrist, right? Because andros are just psychiatrists that at the end of the day, if the child He's the only one who wants to have the puberty blockage. They have the right to take it, or is this another authority, like the parents, who makes a decision? From what I understand, it's like a legal guardianship point. The parents can choose what treatment the children go through, right? Endocrinologist. I'm dyslexic. Oh, okay. Yeah, I know an endocrinologist. An endocrinologist is just a kind of psychiatrist, isn't it? Or am I dumb? Medical specialists who hormones, bro. The endocrine system. Oh, they're just medical doctors in general. Okay, cool. Yeah, I know they deal with hormones. It's that like... Do these laws mean delayed puberty can't be treated? Well, they would have if they didn't get fucking vetoed. So Arkansas's governor on Monday vetoed a bill that would have made the state the first to ban gender-affirming medical care, including surgery for transgender minors, even with parental consent. Governor Asa Hutchinson, a Republican, called the Save Adolescents from Experimentation program a vast government overreach. Based, if you are conservative in... I can show you that after this, Rack. A vast government overreach. If you're a conservative, you shouldn't want the government sticking their fucking hands in people's healthcare and what healthcare decisions they should want to take. If you are like a small government conservative, this is a bad bill for you, right? But these people lie about their positions. He told reporters it would set the new standards of legislative interference with physicians and parents as they deal with some of the most complex and sensitive matters involving young people. The bill approved in House and Senate last month, so it is House and Senate, would bar transgender youth from obtaining gender-affirming care, including puberty blockers and hormone therapy. It would prohibit medical providers from making referrals to other healthcare professionals for gender-affirming procedures for those under 18. Healthcare providers who offered such care would lose their license to practice in the state or be vulnerable to civil litigation. The move by Hutchinson bucks a growing legislative movement at the state level targeting transgender people. Legislative bodies in Tennessee, Texas, and South Carolina have all passed anti-transgender medical care bans at the start of 2021. And several others, including Arkansas, have passed laws banning transgender athletes from competing on sports teams matching their gender identity. Hutchinson's veto may not be the end of the SAFE Act. The Republican-led legislator could still enact the measure since it would only take a simple majority to override the veto. Unfortunately, they are probably going to do that. I feel sorry for the transgender youth in Arkansas. Hopefully they can get the fuck out of that shit state. My band Blindside released our demo today. If y'all could go out and check out my music, I would really appreciate it. It is on Apple Music right now. You can go and listen to my fucking band. It slaps, okay? Fucking, this is it. Where are we? Where's my fucking OBS? Right here. This here. Give this a listen if you got a chance. It'll be up on Spotify today, okay? Blindside demo 2021. That shit is fucking hot, okay?